We are here today because of a horrific incident that took the lives of four family members in East Orange County this morning. At 4 a.m., our communications center received a 911 call from a resident who said that her neighbor had been shot and needed help. So when deputies arrived on the scene, they entered the home on Myers Drive and found three women and a young child, all who were family members, dead from gunshot wounds to the head. The suspect is 23-year-old Chevelle Jordan Jones. He was found on scene alive with an apparent self-inflicted gunshot wound to the head. He's in the hospital right now in surgery. So here's what we know so far. One of the women who was killed was in a relationship with Jones. Overnight, they got into an argument. At some point, Jones began to remove his belongings from the home and then re-entered the home and began shooting. So he murdered the 49-year-old matriarch of the family, her two daughters, 28 and 29-year-old. The 29-year-old is Jones' girlfriend, and tragically, he also killed the matriarch's 4-year-old granddaughter by shooting her in the head. Jones shot another daughter, and this is the woman who went to the neighbor for help. She has survived her injuries. Two other children, 4 and 6-year-olds, were found in the home. They had hid under their blankets when the shooting started, and thankfully we found them unharmed in the home. The suspect in this case has no criminal history to speak of other than a failure to appear for a misdemeanor charge from a couple years ago. There is no history of domestic violence or dating violence involving any of the family members or the suspect that we could find. So it's not clear how long the family has been living in that house, but what I can tell you is our deputies have not responded to that home involving those family members. You know, it's never easy to make sense of these tragedies. You know, I'm a father. I can't imagine or fathom such an incident involving my loved ones. And although this will be very difficult for our detectives and crime scene detectives, as they're all mothers and fathers and aunts and uncles who have young children, they're going to work very, very hard to find some answers and put the pieces together so we can find out why this happened. So at this time, I'm happy to take questions.
Can you clarify who the four people, it was a mother, her daughter, the mother's granddaughter, who was the other person that was killed?
So it was the matriarch of the family, her two daughters, and the matriarch's 4-year-old granddaughter. Another daughter was also shot, but she survived.
How old was the daughter that survived, that went to the neighbor?
She's in her 20s as well.
What is she telling your people about the events that led up to this? Does she know?
Yeah, so apparently what led up to this was some type of argument involving the people inside of the house. And all that's under investigation, but there was definitely an argument. He started to remove his belongings and at some point re-entered the home and began shooting.
The 4-year-old granddaughter, her mother, is she one of the daughters, one of the matriarch's daughters that survived or was killed?
That's correct. So the 4-year-old who was killed and then her twin, the 4-year-old and 6-year-old, are all daughters of the 20-year-old who survived.
Okay. So does she know at this point that one of her children is dead?
Yeah, I'm certain she does.
Yeah. Yes. Is there anything to describe perhaps you know how she's taking this?
Yeah, I can't speak to that. Obviously, you know, as a parent myself, I'm sure she's devastated.
Are you expecting the suspect?
So the suspect, he apparently shot himself in the head. He's at the hospital in surgery. If he does survive, he will be charged with these murders, but it's still too early to tell.
Do you know if they have other family who lives in this area that you can talk to more about and find out more about their relationship?
Yeah, I'm not aware of any other family in this area. And you know, certainly as the investigation progresses, you know, we're very early on in it. We'll be talking to family members and friends and neighbors and to see, you know, what could have led up to this.
How is the mom who was shot? Is she back with her kids? Is she still in the hospital? Where are her kids?
I'm not sure.
Any idea how long this family has been living there? Ballpark estimate?
Within this year. Yeah, we're not sure how, but I believe it's within this year.
Was the gun his? Was it registered to him? And what kind of gun was it?
It was a handgun, and unsure about the registration of the gun.
Everybody good?
Sure. Real quick, if I could ask you, what can you tell us about the DeShayla Ferguson murder investigation right now?
What's that now?
What can you tell us about the DeShayla Ferguson murder investigation right now?
So still under investigation. No further details to release on that one.
Any update on the search for her killer?
Oh, yeah, we have numerous leads, but again, that's still under investigation. And I don't want to release any details about that case.
Everybody good? Thank you, Sheriff.
All right.